today with me is Dr. H.K. Chopra. Sir is immediate past president, Cardiological Society of India, and chairman, National Affairs of Cardiological Society of India. Sir is also editor of STEMI book. Sir, coming to the STEMI, how big is the burden in India?
I think it's very important, Rishi. It's really a pleasure for me to be here this morning on the occasion of 68th Annual Conference of CSI at Kochi. The question asked to me, what is the burden of STEMI in India? I think if you go to the latest data, 60.6 is the burden of CSA out of all the ACS of STEMI. So in the world, India is leading in STEMI. 3 million patients are being reported every year. The mortality is so high and the morbidity is so high. And the unfortunate part is most of our patients are not given the treatment in time. And we know that time is a muscle if you really want to salvage the geopardized myocardium. So I think it's very important that timely intervention is the need of the hour, is the main agenda. How should we achieve this is a real challenge for us. And I personally feel that we must create an app which should have a global standard. For example, everyone in a common man should know signs and symptoms of STEMI. So once you understand how to attack heart attack, if he gets chest pain or discomfort, he may think that probably it's a heart attack. Right. And the second point, he should immediately call the number wherever he is, whether it's a workplace or at some other place. He should have the access to the mobile number so that the ambulance can reach in time. And as the ambulance reach in time, this should be easy access to the ECG. And when we get the ECG, it should go by WhatsApp or by telemedicine to the heart station or by WhatsApp on the mobile of the doctor concerned, whosoever he or she prefers. And then based on the ECG, the instructions can be given directly. Then you can give a drug like TNK on the spot to salvage the time. Pre-hospital thrombolysis is the need of the hour. It has to be given to save the time, because if you see the golden hour for TNK is about 60 minutes. And the golden hour for primary PCI is about 90 minutes to 120 minutes. So early we give TNK, we can make a larger infarct to a smaller one. We can make it transmural to a subendocardial one, or we can abort the MI. There may not be any clot burden at all. There may not be any thrombus inside. So the whole data, any registry data you take worldwide, is in favor of pre-hospital thrombolysis or create a protocol in the EMS. Every EMS should have the same protocol.
True.
And of course, we have to create the hospitals which are PCI-capable hospitals and PCI-non-capable hospitals. PCI-capable hospital, we should ensure that 24 hours there is an interventional cardiologist available. And those who are not PCI-capable, at least in all the hospitals, all the nursing homes, all the medical centers, there should be a feasible approach to give TLT. And the best TLT, which has been reported worldwide by all the registry, whether it's a Vienna registry or it's a registry from the Mayo Clinic or a national registry from India, has reported very nicely that there is a significant reduction in the morbidity and mortality, no hypertension, no hypersensitivity reaction, and the most important agenda is no NTSK antibodies.
True.
It is the NTSK antibodies which are responsible for all hypersensitivity reactions as well as the resistant thrombi. Sometimes there is a non-reperfusion because there is a high titer of NTSK antibodies, because Indians are more prone to get a streptococcal infection.
True. Very true.
So they have high levels of antibodies. So they don't respond adequately. And if you see here, sometimes there is a second peak of reperfusion. So the half-life is also divided. And then the early reocclusion rate is very, very high with streptokinase. We were the first people in India to use streptokinase. We are the first people who are not recommending it as
So for PST, you recommend TNK should be the agent of choice?
I think if you see the data, I'm just telling on the evidence-based data, the TNK is the agent of first choice because of obvious reasons. It is the ease of administration.
True, very true.
We can just give it 5 seconds, the bolus. Anybody can give, anywhere.
Correct.
no hypersensitivity, as I mentioned to you, no hypotension. You're not given the infusion form, no bottle required, no IV set required, no, nothing is required.
And across the globe, I think this is an agent which is used.
Used extensively. I only one request. People always talk of cost. I don't think anything is more expensive than life.
True, very true.
Still, my recommendation is that Government of India should try their best to subsidize the cost as much as possible. Because the recommendation now is not only TNK followed by PCI within 3 to 24 hours. So that's the recommendation. So a patient has to go a double procedure. So it should be cost-effective method.
True.
So the same way we recommend to the PCI also. The cost should be reduced there also. Even for the stents, what they use should be reduced. Ultimately, aim is to save the patient and reduce the morbidity and mortality.
So in the current scenario, we say that PCI is the gold standard, but obviously because of multiple reasons, the patients are not able to reach the hospital in time. So what is the status of pharmaco-invasive approach? Is it the way for Indian patients right now, or still do we recommend that PCI should be the way for everyone?
Rishi, it's a very important question which you asked me. If you see the overall data, there's no doubt that PCI is the gold standard. There's no doubt about it. But the only thing is it really feasible? No,
sure.
It's not feasible. It's not practical. I'm talking in places like Delhi, Bombay, Kolkata,
sure.
Metros. It's not possible. So much of crowd,
true.
Overcrowding, no awareness. People
right.
do not know, and they keep on crippling for about 24 hours, 48 hours, like gastric distension.
Correct.
They don't know.
They don't realize that.
And they can't reach. Ambulance services so poor. So the only solution for India, I will repeat, the only solution for India is pharmaco-invasive approach. Direct PCI feasibility and availability is only in 10% of people. If you say United States, 20%. In United States, only 20% have access to PCI. What to talk of India, where 75% of population is in the rural area.
True.
We must use extensively in the rural areas pharmaco-invasive approach. In both the methods, either pharmaco-invasive approach in the same institution is feasible. If it is not there, then the pharmacological approach in the form of TLT or what we call as TNK can be given instantaneously. And the patient can be shifted to the PCI-capable center
sure.
to salvage the myocardium.
So I think for Indian patients, at least as of now, pharmaco-invasive is the way to go ahead.
It is not only for India, it's worldwide. The okay. reason is people don't have time to reach, whether even USA or China or Japan or Canada or UK. The data says pharmaco-invasive approach is the best solution. Untimely PCI and worst than the timely thrombolytherapy.
True.
And untimely thrombolytherapy is worse than the timely PCI. Decision is yours. You must see how close you are to the PCI center. If it takes only 15-20 minutes to reach the PCI capable center, go for PCI.
Go for PCI.
But if you find there is some discrepancy in the time, because after 90 minutes or 20 minutes, 120 minutes, the benefit of PCI is not achieved. On the contrary, it adds to the morbidity and mortality. This is a very important message.
True, very true.
Which we should consider. And I think, what is the harm? Why should there be any fight? There is no fight. There is no conflict.
True.
Both are working together. So best to give a pharmaco-invasive approach. That's the only way to solve or save the myocardium, which is at risk because of extensive MI.
So what are the three key messages you will like to give to physicians of India, who are the usually the first point of contact for myocardial infarction patients?
Yeah, I think the FMC should be known to everyone. And I tell you, my message is very clear to every physician or a cardiologist who is coming across the patient of STEMI. Number one, educate the patients as to what the STEMI is all about. Number two, make them aware to have the key numbers with them all the time, so they have easy access. And number three, they have a right to ask for pharmaco-invasive approach so they get the right treatment in time. It is their right. It is the right of the patient to ask for it. Sir, I need a clot buster. Following a clot buster, put me to the PCI.
True.
This is a very important message.
Thank you, sir, for your key messages, and congratulations once again for your blockbuster book on STEMI. Thanks a lot, sir.